Hi everybody, it's Sandy, and I'm shooting this on Sunday night, so I'm snuggled in on the daybed, and Punch is down there, and he is having none of coming up here to be on camera. I was hoping he would join us, but we'll see. Anyway, I wanted to post the winners from Friday's video. We did a giveaway of 3 different stamp sets. So the 3 of you, please email me with your 1, 2, 3, and whoever emails first gets first choice. Second gets their top choice, etc. And I think you're going to all be happy with them. I want to thank everybody who bought the Brave stamp set because they are sold out. Yes! They were only going to be available till September 30th, which is tomorrow. And, well, by the time you're seeing this, that will be tomorrow. And they are sold out, though. I'm very excited because we wanted to make sure we got them all gone from the store in time because they were only available for Stamptember. Today I want to show you the start to finish card, and this one is using the Fox set and the stencil. So I'm going to be doing, over the next couple months, a series of stencil videos so that you can see different ways to use stencils, only for the reason that OWH has never had any, so I know lots of you have never dealt with stencils before. So let's go check that out. So we're going to distress the daylights out of a piece of cardstock. I'm using pretty heavy-duty cardstock so that it holds up to all this distressing. I'm using Salty Ocean and Peacock Feathers for this background, and then I'm going to stencil over it. And I'm really pushing hard on my little distress tool because I want lots and lots of ink on here and make it really rich color. So I'm going to go over it twice and try to make it blend in the middle. It's not going to be perfect because it's distressing, but I'm going to try to just smoosh it until I get it looking just the way I want it to. And while I am here chatting, I did talk to Hero Arts just this morning. Yes, I'm recording this after I recorded last night's introduction. And they said that on October 1st, the new stamps and stencils are going to ship to stores that have ordered them. So if your LSS has not yet ordered them, now is a great time to let them know to go place the order for the new Hero Arts stuff. And if they call the office or, you know, do whatever they do to order, they will be able to get those and get them in the store for you. And otherwise, October 15th is when they're going to be in the Hero Arts store on their website. And I'm guessing that there will be a few places that will have them sooner. So as soon as they do, you know I'm going to let you know. So here's the stencil, and I'm going to show you how the stencil lines up. See, there's a little gap down at the bottom when you line it up. This actually fits a 5.5 by 4.25 sheet of paper, but I have my paper cut to 5.25 by 4. That's why I have that little gap around it, which is perfectly fine. So I'm going to washi tape it to the back, and I can center it using that little line at the bottom and just get that centered around the front of the card. And now I'm going to take some vintage photo ink, and I'm just going to pounce it into the openings on the trees. And you have to be careful with stencils if you've not used them before, because all those little pieces can sometimes pull up and you can end up damaging your stencil, and then it gets all kind of warpy and weird, that kind of stuff. And sorry, it's going off screen here a little bit, but I'm just pouncing the ink in there, and you can push a little bit sideways, but you mostly want to just try to go up and down. There's some stencils that are a little more stable than this one, but this has, as you can see, these loose pieces that I have to hold with my finger. So you want to hold that down in place so you don't end up with getting all kinds of triple images on it. This one is going to be really soft, so it's not going to matter if it's a little bit off. But in general, that's kind of how stencils go. So I'm just stenciling through the open spaces on the stencil. And it's going to make all the beautiful trees for the card. So now I'm going to grab some mowed lawn. And I'm going to make the grass at the bottom. I'm just going to stencil right over top of the color that I already had. And it's just going to make it a really rich green instead of the lighter green that I had. I could have peeked a little bit at this and seen if everything's lining up, but I want to wait for the big reveal. So now I'm just pouncing on some unicorn ink with a little dauber to make the moon. How fun is that? Oh my gosh. I'm just loving it. I love this stencil. It's really fun. Now, I wanted to show you a little cleaning that I'm doing with my stencils. I try to wash them fairly quickly because otherwise I won't remember what I last used on them. But since I know this is distress ink, etc., then it's going to clean up with water. So I just put a little bit of whatever I'm cleaning it, or whatever I would clean that ink with,
if I'm using Copic, I would put some colorless blender on there. And I just put a bunch of drops of it on, smoosh it around, and tap it, and not rub it. If you rub it, all those little pieces will come up and you might bend your stencil. And then I just pat it between a dry paper towel. Okay, this is, now we'll go to normal speed. This is the stamp set with the little foxes in it. So stinking cute, oh my gosh. And it's got a whole bunch of sentiments with it too. So we're gonna color the fox. I'm gonna use archival ink because it's waterproof, because I wanna use some distressed inks to watercolor. Now I am watercoloring this on regular cardstock. I'm not using the watercolor cardstock to do this, which I probably should have, but it's such a tiny image and I'm just gonna keep dabbing it so that I don't get pools of water on it. And it's gonna work. It's not gonna be as sturdy as it would be if I did it on the distress watercolor card stock. But I'm just painting the color on using the ink that I've got on my craft mat and keeping it really pretty simple. I'm just not coloring the faces and the tips of the tails, and I'm gonna trim it out so it doesn't matter if I go outside the lines. Now I can also go directly from the ink pad. Yeah, that's the word I'm looking for. It's Monday, oh my gosh. So I'm going to use some aged mahogany and I'm going to add a second color to it and watercolor right over it. Now you can dry it in between because sometimes you'll get a better straight effect. If you're looking for texture, you'll get more of that. This is going to be really soft because the paper is still wet. And that is a water brush I'm using, by the way. I'll put links in the doobly-doo to the products that I'm using if you need to go see what they are. And I'm just gonna paint a little bit of that color on and let it fade into the other color and allow the red and the orange color to mix. Now, if I used more like a regular paintbrush and I didn't use as much water, so if I used more of the ink itself, I would get a richer color. But I wanted just a really soft little watercolory fox picture on this card. I'm gonna add a little bit more of the orange and just to try to darken a little bit of that, just a bit. Not doing a very good job of darkening because I've got too much water in my water brush, but it's still going to be fine because I really like the soft pastelliness of it. I think it's pretty sweet. So now I'm going to fussy cut. These don't have dies with them. There are dies in the Stampin' Cut set, but they're not dies for the critters. So you'll still have to fussy cut, but it's such a simple shape. It's very much like the Little Hoots. So here's my card base. It's white on the inside. Hero Art sells those. And I'm just attaching my piece directly to the cardstock. And I'm gonna use a power tab to stick this on. These power tabs stick really well to distressed ink. Sometimes distressed ink doesn't like to take any kind of adhesive on the front of it because it gets a little bit on the slick side, especially when you put as much ink as I did on this one. So I wanted to make sure I did that correctly and got it really good and stuck. So now I'm going to use the archival ink on this as well because this ink plays really nice with all of this distress ink. And I'm going to fill in the word blue with a blue distress marker. This is Salty Ocean as well. And you can see here the Salty Ocean is the color at the top in the distressing, and then it's the color coming out of the marker. So when you use the marker direct, it's crazy dark blue compared to what it is when you use it with other techniques. So it has a lot of versatility to it depending on the strength that you use for the actual application of the ink.
Thank you so much for joining me for this video. Please leave a comment in the doobly-doo. Winners, don't forget to email me, sandy@operationwrighthome.org. And I will see you guys probably Wednesday. I think it's sit rep day coming up. See ya!